Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the English News Edition brought to you live from RTD channel. Coming up in this edition, the head of state Malia Margulies presides over the work of the sixth meeting of the ministers council, and on the regional news in Somalia, a resignation of the president of the National Assembly. Let's get into the details now. Under the chairman chief of the head of state, Ismaila Margulies, was held the sixth meeting of the ministers council on this Tuesday 10 April. 11 bills were on the agenda and details with the Minister of Foreign Affairs and International Corporations.
Sous la présidence du chef de l'État, son excellence Monsieur Ismaila Margulies s'est tenu.
Under the chairmanship of the head of state, His Excellency Ismaila Margulies held the sixth meeting of the Council of Ministers in this Tuesday, 10 April 2018, were listed on the agenda 11 questions. The first question is relative has a draft law on ratification of the loan agreement signed between the Republic of Djibouti and Kuwait Fund for Development in the framework of its energy policy and its programs of development of renewable energy, including the energy geothermal. Our country has contracted this project ready to close to 4.5 billion of Djibouti franc. This funding includes the construction of a central 15 megawatt in the area of Kalakoma and services of consultation. This central of energy geothermal will contribute to the effort of government aimed at the satisfaction of electricity demand of our population. The conditions of the loan are concessional basis with a period of maturity of 25 years, including a grace period of 5 years and a right of interest of 2% per year. The second question concerns a bill establishing urban rehabilitation and social housing agency, ARULOS. This bill aims to dissolve the establishment of housing fund and the organizations of the new structure that replaces it, namely the Urban Rehabilitation and Social Housing Agency. The establishment of this agency is part of a global framework for the revitalization of the structure in charge of implementation of the housing policy to be able to face the challenges of the production of social housing, to the rehabilitation of precarious neighborhood, and to loan regularization. The Urban Rehabilitation and Social Housing Agency is entrusted with the operational missions of the Habitat Fund. The three round questions is related to a bill create the real estate and land development company. The missions and role of the institution currently in place have been redefined so that the new institution focuses on a specific mission. The purpose of the present bill is to dissolve the Djibouti Real Estate Company and to organize the new structures to replace it, the Real Estate and Land Development Company. This new company is an operational body responsible for the implementation of land development operation, namely the production and marketing of service plot to support public and private real estate development. The first question is concerned draft arrest important assignment to the Minister of Muslim Affairs of Culture and Property, Waqf, a parcel of land. This parcel of land of 10,000 meter squares in Balbala, Pika 12 Northeast, is intent for the establishment of commercial activity. The fifth question is related to a proposed major decision to award a parcel of land for considerations to Al Group. This parcel is of 224,000 meter at Nagat subdivision is intent for the implementation of real estate project. Al Awil Group is responsible for the realization of all advertising and miscellaneous work and embankment. The deadline for completion of the work is 24 months from the signing of the current order.
Part of the Minister's Council with the spokesperson of the government.
Est relative à un projet de décret portant nomination.
The sixth question concerns a major draft decision amending decision 2014. This is the partial amendment and relating to the area of land of 680 hectares in the Ministry of Housing District from 100 hectares to the benefit of the Ministry of Agriculture. 100 other hectares are distracted to the benefit of the Djiboutian Armed Forces. The remainder of 400 hectares continue to be allocated to the benefit of the Ministry of Housing. The seventh question is concern a project of stopped on the assignment of a parcel of land for the benefit of the Ministry of Agriculture. A parcel of land sits in Duda. 100 hectares is put at the disposal of the company called Acno Energy with a view to the establishment of a complex agro-energy. The eighth question is relative drastically concerning the appointment of officials at the Ministry of Women and Family. Yasmin Salim Said is appointed Secretary General of the Ministry of Women and Family. Nabila Salman Hassan is appointed Technical Advisor to the Ministry of Women and Family. Saida Musa Ali is appointed Technical Advisor of the Ministry of Women and Family. Ismail Muhammad Ismail is appointed Technical Advisor of the Ministry of Women and Family. Usman Jama Usman is appointed Technical Advisor of the Ministry of Women and Family. Shukri Hussein Jibah is appointed Director of the Promotions of Kind. Fozia Ali Usman is appointed Director of Family. Ahmed Humad Mohammadi is appointed Director of Financial Administrative. Rokia Ali Tubet is appointed Director of the Management of the Project. Ali Umar Ali is appointed Director of Statistical Study of the Planning and Tracking Evaluation. Roda Ahmed Duali is appointed Director of Center for Social Action, the Empowerment of Women. The ninth question is Act the insurance, the rule of separation between insurer and care and managers of plan provide in its Article 37 declarations by stopped and a commission to assess the movable and immovable heritage as well as the financial asset of two centers of care of the CNSS. The project of current stop to create fixed the compositions of the member of the said commission to evaluate the heritage and centers of care of the CNSS. The tenth question is concerned a bill on the creation of the Center for Entrepreneurship and Leadership. The development of markets in the sectors of Djibouti has a comparative advantage through the entrepreneurship remain a priority for the government to ensure a sustainable growth and allow the country to reach its objectives of country emergent. This political materialized on the establishment of a center of entrepreneurship and private sector in parallel to the reform for the improvement of the business climate committee since a few years. The activity of the cell will turn around the coordination and reform of the program of entrepreneurship and development of business. At the end of the session, the Minister of Higher Education has made a report to the Council of the visit to Djibouti to a delegation of Chairman Karl Ruhe, responsible for the scientific cooperation in the field of energy and technology. The Minister of Habitat has for his part reported to the Council of its participation in the Conference of a Structural Dialogue with Africa of Green Background for their Climate Health in Bamako from 3 to 6 April 2000.
And still with the national news, the French Djibouti Business Group had this morning a meeting with the Minister of Foreign Affairs and International Cooperation, Mohamed Ali Youssouf. The objectives were to learn about the business climate in order to allow French investors to settle down and take advantage of the various potentialities offered by Djibouti, which has annual growth of more than 77%. The Foreign Minister, Mohamed Ali Youssouf, has invited French business groups already present in Djibouti to explain the business that thrives more easily with the implementation of major infrastructure that facilitate access. Recalling that the France Djibouti Business Group is created just 6 months ago to promote the potentiality of Djibouti and to expand their markets to both countries, Djibouti as well France. On last February 22, the government of Djibouti created the new Container Terminal Management Company, SGTD. This new entity known as SGTD has to cover the Dorale Container Terminal port operations after a termination of the contract with DP World. Mandaq Mohamed tells us more.
On February 22, 2018, the government of Djibouti created the new Container Terminal Management Company, SGTD. This new entity known as the SGTD has took over the Dorale Container Terminal Port operations after termination of the contract with DP World. The entity responsible for the management, the CSD, this new national company in the state, is the only shareholder mission to defend the interest of the nation, to promote the port activities with a quality of service that meets the international needs. 6 weeks later, first is to note that Djibouti SGTD Terminal Management Company have duplicated those activities. It is a clear increase in volume and transshipment of vessels is recorded. In his intervention said, "We are satisfied by the performance that had been made since 22 February by the new management society of Dorale. Indeed, the organization of the new port have progressed and brought an increasing productivity which is equivalent to 40%. The port productivity has increased significantly from 67% to 77% per year just in 1 month. During this same period, the number of the daily trucks served has also increased with more than 700 trucks compared to the former DCT company, which limited the activities of the import-export traffic to the local markets and to Ethiopia. The cumulative volume of the annual activity accounted for about 80,000 containers per year, while the port of the container terminal was designed to 1,600,000 containers per year. Followed his speech with saying that the capacity of containers for Djibouti and Ethiopia were 150,000 containers, and we have invested for nearly 1,600,000 containers. It was clear at the beginning that what we were expecting for the transportship was not there, and after 9 years we were at 57% of the capacity of the terminal. Other similarities, strategic actors have already expressed their wishes to accompany the Republic of Djibouti to take part in the port development of Djibouti. It is particularly the French ship owners CMA CGM, one of the world leaders in container shipping. The head of the company CMA CGM expressed their willingness to the president of the authority of port and free zone, Mr. Abdul Qadir Omar Haddi, during his participation in Africa Forum taking place in Ivory Coast. Lately, Mr. Abdul Qadir said it was a very important forum. He said, which every country in Africa had their attention on Djibouti, and a lot of investors have showed their interest to Djibouti and said they want to invest in our country. One of those interested were the country of Chad, who actually used the port of Sudan, that said they want to use the port of Djibouti as well for import and export of their goods to Chad. A new area begins to the terminal management company SGTD managing the Dorale Container Terminal port. Today, the port of Dorale has taken over, and it is a track for global competitiveness.
The extraordinary and plenipotentiary ambassador of the Republic of Djibouti to the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia participated in his capacity as Dean of the Diplomatic Corps in Riyadh alongside Dr. Abdullah Al-Rabi'i, Counselor of the King and General Supervisor of the King Salman Center for the Relief and Humanitarian Aid at the launching ceremony of the Saudi Arabia Aid Distribution Project for the year 2018. In his speech, the Ambassador of Djibouti delivered a speech of thanks to Saudi Arabia in general and to the King Salman Center in particular for the efforts made in the field of support and assistance presented to the international organization as well as to the governments of the countries brothers. The Secretary General of MINFOP, Mohamed Abdullah Mahyoub, sponsored last Sunday the draw of the school competition Young Champions 2018 in the presence of the Director General of the Education, Abdi Diriragiri, the Executive Secretary of the Supervisor Council of Education, Ayan Osman Abrar, as well as the Director of Public Education, Lula Ali Ilabi, and members of the Minister's Office. Many heads of basic, middle, and high schools also took part in the draw, which defined the calendar of events as well as opposition between schools. Launched last year, these fun and educational games offer questions related to classes and topics studied in class in general subjects such as science, mathematics, but also the French language and history, geography in the same ways as sport. The Secretary General of MINFOP has emphasized the interest of these games and their interest for students who find a healthy emulation in these competitions. And he also explained in detail the rules of the games and competition schedule for the 2018 edition. The Tajura Community Development Center organized a cultural event this Thursday with the book exhibition written by the writer Hamad Gabamaki Ibrahim. This book, written by this great writer, pioneer in writing in Afro language, will be exhibited within the Tajura's CDC so that the young then discover their cultural heritage and book written in their mother language. This event was organized by the CDC of Tajura in close collaboration with the association Taguri Ela, which works actively in the promotion of culture. The organizers, Mr. Barogoita and the head of CDC of Tajura, Muhammad Ali, did not fail to thank all the participants and congratulate the writer, Muhammad Gaba, author of several books that young will discover. And as part of the fight against smuggling of contraband goods, the Al Sabih Detachment Police, in close collaboration with the Customs Brigade of Al Sabih region, arrested yesterday a quantity of bags of cat smuggled at the border of Galilee, were seized that in this business, a commodity of cat composed of 115 packets of cat and 13 kilo. The smugglers wanted to convey in quantity in the city of Al Sabih. This quantity was destroyed in the presence of the Customs Brigade and the police. The National Commission on Eligibility, chaired by the Secretary General of the Ministry of the Interior and Chairman of the Committee, Siraj Omar Abdul Qadir, has served at ONAR's headquarters this morning in accordance with the decree number 2017-409, laying down the rules of procedures, the organizational and operational modalities of bodies responsible for managing the status of refugees in Djibouti. The National Commission is composed by a representative of the Presidency, the Ministry of the Interior, the Ministry of Justice, as well as the Foreign Affairs and Health Ministry. The work of the institution is coordinated and planned by ONARS, whose Executive Secretary Hussein Hassan assured the Vice President of the Commission. The purpose of this commission is to study and examine the files of asylum seekers and to decide whether or not to grant refugee status. And for the promotion of the sport activity, the president of the Djibouti Federation has met the main actors of football. The main objective is to take together a challenge of tomorrow for the future of the national football at the technical center. These meetings will take place till April 16. Represent coaches and football family assets in order to develop and promote national football. And now on the regional news, Speaker of Somalia's Parliament resigns. Somalia's Speaker of Parliament, Mohamed Osman Jawari, has resigned after a three-week power struggle with the country's Prime Minister official, Minister Abdurrahman Hosh Jibril, announced in a tweet that Speaker Jawari had submitted his resignation. Member of Parliament Hussein Arab Issa also told to the VOA Somali that the Speaker has resigned. So that's it for the news. Thanks for being with us on Atelier Channel.